चांदनी ने पुन्ने आते जल सा लगाया सता झील नू भी आया चंद मुख मेहमान सी चांदनी ने पुन्ने आते जल सा लगाया सता झील नू भी आया चंद मुख मेहमान सी रिश्माने रिश्माने और रिश्माने दूधिया जे पाई सी पोशाक मारी तारिया नू हाक ओता हो रही जहान सी और रिश्माने दूधिया जे पाई सी पोशाक मारी तारिया नू हाक ओता हो रही जहान सी
We met first time in Saket. Then after that, I met her in a house party at my place, which was thrown by my other friend with my brother. So I asked her to my friend, so is she dating or is she single? Then he said, yeah, pata nahi, and all that thing happened. Then I said, I want to meet her. So he passed on the message to her that SSI is a girl. And all that. That is around 8th of Feb in 2015. But then after that, we met on 15th of Feb for the first time, like first time alone. And she told me after hi and how are you, that I'm about to get married in less than one year. So I'm like, theek hai, dekhte hain. I'm like, let's try, okay, fine, that is okay with me. But let's see kya hota hai aage. Then, but that first meeting, I can say that she was smitten by me. She will never agree on that, because for 45 minutes we talked in the parking lot, and she was getting late. She has to meet her mother and she was getting late, and we are still managed to talk for 45 minutes. That's how we met for the first time.
Kal raat sapno mein मुझको मिली थी तू यहाँ तू सना कहती थी मुझे जाना नहीं तू वो तू ही थी जो लगती थी हूँ सना से वो ताल गल रही थी आंखों
met in Delhi. We'd met a couple of times already, and I always used to think that this guy is really sweet, but never gave much thought about the fact ki kya hai, kaisa hai. Finally, we started dating. What I really like about this guy is he's very grounded. Like, he's the voice of reason to my usually very corrupted emotional state of mind. Can always put sense into those holes that are probably illogical in a lot of senses. And he's always the sensible guy in between the two of us. I am more emotional, always find everyone really nice. He'll be like, maybe you need to see the other side of the coin. I think that is something that I really like about him. And also the fact that he can, you know, not a lot of people can go an extra mile for you. He will always go that extra mile for you. He doesn't even make you feel like he went an extra mile. He'll just do it. That's his nature. That's how he is. Franch was supposed to come and visit me in Turin when I was studying there, and somehow his visa couldn't get through because his planning was a little off, and then he was supposed to leave for his sale, while he was about to leave for his sale, he got his ticket and he told me, listen, my transit is through Paris. Is there any possibility that you could come meet me? And this is, I think, an evening before he was about to fly out. So I'm like, okay, let me see what are the options, whether I can fly from Turin or not. And I'm like, okay, let's see. I check up on everything and I tell him, I said, listen, I could go to Milan tonight. There's a direct flight for Paris in the morning. And maybe I could meet you in Paris. Not realizing that, okay, I'll reach Paris, but is there a possibility or not if I can actually meet him? I reach Paris. By the time he's already landed, 7 o'clock in the morning, and he sent me a message. And he's like, I don't think there's a possibility that we could meet. Meanwhile, I am already in a flight. I land, I open my phone, I see the message, and I'm like, shit. We are there. We're literally minutes away from each other, but we can't actually meet. So I'm obviously very upset. He was in the international zone. I had the Shenzhen visa. He didn't have any visa. There was no possibility of us actually, you know, colliding with each other or being able to meet. So yeah, and I go up to this lady. I go up to this lady, Air France kiosk, and I go up to her. There's this really cute black lady. She had very short hair. I go up to her and I tell her my sob story. I'm like, this is what has happened. My boyfriend is right there. I can actually see him, but I can't meet him. And she's like, okay, what is your, which passport do you hold? I said, I'm an Indian. She's like, you know, maybe you could buy a fully flexible ticket to Mumbai, which I did, and it almost emptied my entire accounts. I told Pranch, I said, listen, this is the only way out. I can meet you for about 2-3 hours. And this lady tells me, listen, you have to come back if you need your money back within 3 hours, which is close to about noon that day. And I'm like, okay, fine, 3 hours is good, better than nothing. And finally buy that ticket and go and meet him. We spent some good 2-2.5 hours with each other. I think it was the game changer in our relationship also, because we realized that if we could go to this extent of trying to meet each other, we'll go to all extents to be with each other. And yeah, that's how we met in Paris. Although for just 2 hours, never actually leaving, having left the airport, but we met in Paris.
Jump and go.